Twice a year, about 50 million waterbirds fly huge distances between their northern breeding grounds and their southern wintering areas. This migration route is called a flyway. The East Asian-Australasian Flyway is one of the 9 migratory routes in the world. The East Asian-Australasian Flyway stretches across 22 countries, from Alaska in the US and Siberia in Russia, south through East and Southeast Asia, to Australia and New Zealand. It is home to over 200 migratory waterbird species. Over millions of years, these birds have evolved to take advantage of the abundant food resources in or close to the Arctic Circle. An arduous journey that is worthwhile because there is abundant insect food and relatively few predators in the summertime, enabling them to raise their offspring more easily and quickly. However, when winter comes, they must migrate to the south to avoid the freezing temperatures. Some birds, such as the bar-tailed godwit, can migrate over 10,000 kilometers without stopping and may lose almost half of its body weight. Yet not all of these birds can fly from their breeding site to their wintering site without stopping. Many rely on wetlands, such as tidal mudflats, lakes and rivers, with the rich food resources as stepping stones, places to rest and refuel. It is not only the migratory waterbirds that rely on these wetlands. Human beings do too. We rely on wetlands for food, and wetlands provide important ecosystem services such as water purification, carbon storage, nutrient recycling, and protection of our shorelines. Now, due to competition for land and resources, migratory birds are facing many threats. Habitat loss due to rapid economic development and an increasing human population in the East Asian-Australasian Flyway means that many important habitats are rapidly disappearing. Illegal hunting with guns, traps and mist nets, egg collecting, invasive species, pollution and climate change are all additional threats to these migratory waterbirds. Nobody and no country alone can save these migratory waterbirds. To ensure they are safe along the flyway requires teamwork. That is why, in 2006, the East Asian-Australasian Flyway Partnership, or EAAFP, was established as a framework for international cooperation for the conservation of migratory waterbirds and their habitats. Today, the EAAFP has 37 partners, including 18 country governments, 6 intergovernmental organizations, 12 international non-governmental organizations, and 1 private company. It is a unique cooperation dedicated to promoting waterbirds and wetland conservation. In the EAAFP working groups and task forces, government representatives, site managers and experts discuss the issues, develop strategies, and take actions to protect key threatened species and areas of concern in the flyway. One of the key elements of the partnership is the Flyway Network Site System. It helps to ensure that a network of internationally important sites in the East Asian-Australasian Flyway are sustainably managed to support the long-term survival of migratory waterbirds. EAAFP, together with its partners and supporters, also initiates and implements educational activities, as well as providing tools to promote knowledge and understanding of waterbirds and wetlands to different stakeholders. One important activity is to participate in the World Migratory Bird Day, a global awareness-raising campaign focusing on the conservation of migratory birds and their habitats. Such cooperative activities are yielding results. For example, the recovery of the endangered black-faced spoonbill. With support from the Korean government since 2009, the EAAFP established a secretariat office in Incheon in the Republic of Korea to better promote the work of the EAAFP. Continuous efforts are crucial to conserve habitats, raise awareness about migratory birds and the threats they face. Therefore, the EAAFP has recently adopted a new 10-year strategic plan during Mach 10 in 2018, aiming to work closer together and to reach out to wider audiences. In addition, the science unit based in Beijing was established in 2018 to enhance scientific researches and studies in the flyway. Migratory birds connect people and continents. Let's work together to celebrate migratory water birds and to ensure that they and the people they connect thrive.